Hey Lego fans, it's Jang here from JANGBRiCKS.com with a look at a 1992 Lego system set called the Backhoe, set number 6662. Got this used off eBay in pretty good condition, and I thought I'd share with you a little look at this. I did get it all in pieces, so I had the benefit of being able to put it together, and let me tell you, I love this build. First off, the minifig, classic, yeah, original style of just regular head, and he's got the red overalls on, he's got the nice construction helmet on, and no print on the back for anything here, but yeah, cool little guy. Got two little road signs here which are just printed, not stickered, but printed 2x2 tiles, and then they put a little 1x2 plate on the back of it, makes it stand up. Very simple, but works pretty nicely. I'm not sure if that's exactly the appropriate signage for the construction site that they want you to set up, but hey, I'm happy to get more of these printed pieces. You do get a couple of minifig accessories here in the form of a push broom in brown and a shovel in good old original dark gray. Now, let's move those aside and look at the equipment itself. It's called Backhoe, but it's actually a hybrid backhoe front loader, a very popular and very versatile piece of heavy equipment. This one to me looks kind of like a Ford in its design, kind of its shape and such. You got the different sized tires, front and rear. The front loader has a hinged bucket, so you can bring that up like so. And you've got the little levers back here, so you can actually, without touching the bucket, you can raise it like so. Pretty cool. That goes all the way up here. You can really get your load very high up in the air and see right through there, or you can carry it low like you're supposed to. Got a couple little headlight bits put on there, a little bit of a front bumper sort of detail. The cab does give you these clear, this is 2 1x2x1 clear bricks that give you a little bit of visibility, so your operator can see through there and see exactly where the bucket is hitting pretty straightforward and easily, so that's nice. The dark cylinders in there, the black cylinders, are to indicate a little bit of engine detail or something related to the engine. The cab allows the minifigure to be inserted from the top. This whole top thing actually comes up. I am missing one detail with this, unfortunately. It's supposed to have a sunroof. It's supposed to be a clear piece that works like this. So this is a blue one, obviously, but it would be exactly that, but in clear, would be up here on the top. But open that up, and your minifig can go in forward or backward. I'm gonna put them in backwards for starters. You can pretty much just set them in place, or you can push them down into the studs. And then he's going to be able to, you've got this nice wide window in the back, and he's going to be able to operate the backhoe. Here, if you want to operate the backhoe, put your bucket down, then put these stands down. They fold down, very nice, gives you stability. And then you've got the full ability to reach way out. Look at that reach with that. Wow, that's incredible. Very nice little bucket here, small, and you can just dig down and pick things up like so. It's just a beautiful, beautiful operation. Everything is so smooth. Look at that. God, I love it. I love it. I love it. I love it. I've always liked backhoes, but this one has done so well. It's not even a recent set. I mean, so many things about this are just amazing. The way that they did this, technique I've never thought of before myself. You've got two turntables here. So this piece with the hinge on it is a turntable, and there's a turntable underneath of it. So it gets to be pinched, and just the bottom section of the top turntable is what's actually moving around. That works really well. A lot of smooth surfaces here. Smooth, smooth. They use tiles. There you can see the operator facing forward. This is awesome. This is a great little set. Such a nice little thing. Fairly intricate and advanced in its design, especially for how old it is. And I think that this would fly as a set even today, and actually be quite well liked. So I love the fact that I was able to actually get one of these and go through the process of building it myself. And I hope that you enjoyed this look at it also. And I hope that you'll stick around to see more reviews of new stuff and old stuff, as well as custom builds. So watch for all the latest updates at JANGBRiCKS.com, and you can subscribe to the channel if you want to get updates on just the videos. Thanks again for watching, and I'll talk to you again soon.